Hello there, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to another episode here on Pastiche of Skin. Today we are checking out the Black Friday sale on the PlayStation Network. Thank you very much for joining us. This is available only to the American store, as far as I know at the moment. There is a sale probably oncoming for the most festive of seasons, but in the UK and Europe, and of course in Japan and Hong Kong. But of course Black Friday is the big thing in the States, so they've started in for this for the Thanksgiving weekend. So let's take a little look as we go into the store. Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock, and jingle bell chimes, and jingle bell rhymes. Here it is, the Black Friday sale. TGI Black Friday, save up to 70%, save up to 80% if you're actually on PlayStation Plus. So let's take a look at the list here. Obviously, I don't use PlayStation Plus on my American accounts, so this is going to be a little bit of a mixed bag in pricing. I'm going to have to try and do translation of prices into my head for UK prices, but mostly this will be just looking at the games for the value of what they are themselves and at a 30% or 40% discount whether or not it's worthwhile. So let's jump into the list here and take a quick look and see. Overwatch Origins Edition is available at a 34% discount. Now, after the last weekend where we had Sombra actually available for all the people who hadn't paid for the game to play it for a couple of days, if you haven't already been sold on the idea of Overwatch as a game, this price difference is not going to persuade you, but if you did enjoy it, you've probably already bought it. Overwatch is a massive, massive game, and it's going to be continuing on to be big for a long time from now, so I don't see why a price drop of about 30, 40% on it is going to persuade you any more or less than the gameplay already has whenever you got to play it for 3 days for free. Rainbow Six Siege, Tom Clancy, for $24.99. With a 50% discount, Rainbow Six is very different from what I remember Rainbow Six series being like, and this game has an issue with if you're not playing in a communicated group with a bunch of friends, this can be a little bit of a shit show. If you're going to be buying this, I imagine you're going to be buying this as a group of four people, so you're spending $100 all in if you haven't already got it otherwise. So Rainbow Six Siege, great fun, but again, a very focused squad-based combat that requires you to actually communicate with your other players very, very heavily. Now, across the Grand Theft Auto 5 for $29.99. At 50% off, that's actually a decent price, but I have seen this game going for cheaper. I'm pretty sure I bought it during the last sale for cheaper than this. I suppose with the price change exchange rate, it would have been cheaper just at that time due to the pound being weaker. But yeah, the Grand Theft Auto 5 for $29.99, if you're there for the single player, it's a decent price. If you're there for the multiplayer, it's a much better price. I'm really not into GTA Online. I'm a little bit disappointed by its lack of kind of solo playability. You really are playing in a group again, and getting up in pubs for big raids and stuff is not really the most opportune way of doing it. You kind of hope to have at least one or two people who have already played it before. So yeah, GTA 5 is a good game. Great release. Of course, we're all hotly anticipating the more information about Red Dead Revolver 2 or Red Dead Redemption 2 or what are they calling this new one? Red Dead Resurrection? So they're going to go with the something or other. But yeah, GTA 5 is a great game. And it looks fantastic on the PlayStation 4. So you can pick it up for a reasonably decent price, about 50% off. Obviously, probably up to about 60 if you're actually playing on PS Plus. So Tom Clancy's Rainbow Six Siege Gold Edition, same thing I said about Rainbow Six Siege, just with more stuff unlocked from the beginning, not really a great idea in my opinion. Game of the Year Edition of Middle-Earth, Shadows of Mordor. This game is amazingly fun, it's really good crack. I personally enjoy the main story and not the additional side story where you play as the Elf Lord. The difficulty level ramps up and it's a good fun game for people who really want good completionism and get through all the content, but just playing through the main game itself of Shadows of Mordor, great fun. The nemesis system is really enjoyable. There's nothing more enjoyable than actually just like hunting down one guy who managed to kill you whenever you're working your way through the entirety of the campaign story mode. Yeah, I highly recommend checking this out. At $9.99, it's great. At the increased discount of the PS Plus, it's probably about down to $7 mark. This is a game worth getting. This is actually one of the top ones to grab out of the sale that I can see so far. Grand Theft Auto San Andreas. Of course, that was available in other offers and previously. It is the HD PS4 release of an original PS2 game. If you want to go back in history and try it San Andreas, go ahead and do so. But at $10, you can probably still pick up a copy of this on a PS2 for cheaper. If you're since at this point you're paying for convenience to have it on the PS4. Terraria PS4 edition for $4.99. Now, if you're a kind of person who's into crafting worlds, Terraria is great fun. It's a massively explorable space. It's constantly getting upgrades along the way or updates along the way. My nieces and nephews absolutely adore it. So at $5, you could probably lose your child to this game for a very, very, very long time. And it's a crafty world where you cut down things and you go on misadventures on a two-dimensional plane. Enjoy it. At $4.99, it's 75% off. You're probably not going to see this much cheaper for a long period of time. And for the time to value investment, $4 is nothing at all. Destiny, the collection for $44.99. If you're a Destiny fan still, after all these couple of years, all this time, like the game had a 10-year plan. I don't know if the 10-year plan involved 3 years of on-ramping until it was actually really properly playable, but everything after the first two expansion packs the new one's called Iron Banner, so what was it, The Taken King was the third one, where they made a lot of changes to the system, made this game a lot more playable. I've seen my friends lose a lot of time to play in Destiny. It feels to me, I never really got what they were trying to do with Destiny, because it felt like all the plot and interesting stuff was going on outside of the actual game, rather than actually being involved in the playthrough. It definitely doesn't have the action RPG or action MMORPG kind of tone that it was intended for it, I think. But yeah, it's still a very enjoyable game. Go and drop into it at $44.99 if you want, but you can play vanilla for nothing, I think, for the first few levels. So if you don't know if you want to play this, play the demo first. Play the first few levels of the vanilla and see if you can get into the gear and looting system more than anything else. Because once you get into that kind of like niche of enjoying the hunt down for loot and expanding your gear, then you'll probably find a lot of enjoyment within Destiny. I don't think the far end game raid content and stuff ever interested me, so it was never ever going to draw me forever. Destiny at $44.99, it's 25% off. It's not a massive saving. After Christmas, this game's going to drop in price a lot anyway, so I'd say avoid it for now as part of the sale. You're probably going to see it cheaper very, very soon. Darksiders 2, the definitive edition for the PS4 at full price, full game at $8.99. Darksiders, fun game, interesting character design. I love the mask, but at $8.99, this is a hard choice, because Darksiders was a fun game. Good action-oriented combat, but I don't know if I would actually still want to play through it again or play it from beginning to end in any way, shape, or form. It'd be one of those things, like if I saw a friend playing, he's like, "Hey, give me a control of that and let me have a few minutes on it." But I would probably I'd probably move on from it very quickly. At $8.99, it's a very, very competitive price. I suppose it's probably cheaper under the PS Plus by another 10%. Yeah, at the PS Plus price, yes. At this price, no. It's that thin line between being really good, being a good deal, and being a really cheap deal. And I don't know, it doesn't apply to me in this particular case. The Witcher Complete Edition at $29.99. It's The Witcher 3 Complete. It has all the expansion add-on stuff. The Witcher is a game that if you bought it now and played it straight through to New Year's, you'd probably be about, what, 40-50% through the whole in-game content with the majority of time that it takes to play through. The Witcher series has been fantastic. A little bit harder to get into for console players, especially with the first one, considering there was no mappable controls to control pads on the PC whenever I was playing it. I enjoyed Witcher 2. I haven't finished. I barely scratched the surface of Witcher 3 just because I don't have time to play through such an entrenching game. But the lore, the world, the characters, and the design are very, very well done. The Witcher 3 at $29.99 for all of it, all the expansion-y bits, great. I think I paid $24 for mines whenever I originally bought it, and that was without all the expansions. Yeah, it's at $29.99. If you're going to play all of the content, yes. If you're dipping your toe into The Witcher for the first time, maybe not. That's where I would actually draw the line, especially if you haven't played Witcher 1 and 2. If you've played either one of those games and want to play Witcher 3, this is actually a pretty decent deal because you'll probably burn your way through all the content anyway. Tales of the Borderlands Season Pass for $2.99. This is actually one of the best Tales of series, the best Telltale series that I actually enjoyed whenever I was doing the Tales of series you can see on the channel. Tales from the Borderlands is amazingly funny, really interesting, exciting, didn't have as many glitches as I even had with some of the earlier Telltale Games. Solid, solid fun. At $2.89, definitely a buy. Grab this. The $2.99, if you haven't, or if you're not going to buy like the Telltale Season Pass bundle, which has all of The Walking Dead's, The Wolf Among Us, Tales from the Borderlands, and Game of Thrones in it, then buy this alone. This is just good fun to actually give for somebody as a gift for like to entertain them for a good few hours. It's a TV series that you control. I enjoyed the adventure that I went through in it. I loved the selections I made. Didn't feel like there was actually a dovetailing that a lot of those Telltale stories do. It felt like there was a good possibility number of like interesting style endings I could have seen, while still at the end up coming to the same conclusion point, which most of these stories do. So yeah, Tales from the Borderlands, highly, highly recommended at $2.99, and of course probably is even cheaper on PS Plus. The MLB The Show 2016. Major League Baseball. I don't know nothing about baseball. Could this one be good? Yeah. Personally, I still believe that arcade baseball games are a little bit more fun. The Super Mega Baseball game is really good fun. I would probably go for that over this because I don't know players and care for players. But if you are massively into the game, MLB The Show is obviously the show. At $14.99, it's last year's edition. I'm pretty sure you can probably pick this up for around about the same price, if not cheaper, in store on a physical copy for a better price, and probably be able to resell it even for like $1 or $2 after you're finished over the holidays. So I would say to avoid it. That's my opinion just on any sports game that has a yearly franchise. Dishonored Definitive Edition. With the sequel out, Dishonored, the original Definitive Edition on PS4, is a good price at $11.99. It's a great game, but I don't know. If you're going to go and play Dishonored 2, definitely worth a buy at this price. But if you're not worrying about playing Dishonored 2 just yet, and you want to kind of like pick and choose what you're going through in this seal, Dishonored, well, if it's all, it's essentially it's murder porn simulator 2014. I think it was 2014 whenever the game came out. Dishonored is a great game, really, really fun to play. It encourages sneaky kills and encourages you with a moral choice system not to use your ridiculously overpowered abilities to murder everything to get the good ending in it. But otherwise, $11.99 for a Definitive Edition. I don't like encouraging these remasters on new consoles whenever the old console version was just fine as it was. If you have a PS3, pick it up on the PS3 for even cheaper. Meanwhile, on the PS4, this isn't too bad of a price if you're never going to be looking at it otherwise. Dishonored Definitive Edition, $11.99. It's alright. Batman, the Telltale game series, $17.49 for the full season pass. Now, I've seen the playthrough of the first episode of the Batman series and kind of didn't want to because I wanted to play it through myself as part of the Telltale game series, and I was so uninterested in what was going on and the way it's being played that I really probably will not play this until it's down to the price that Tales from the Borderland is, around about $2-$3 for the entire season. They need to do something different. I think the Telltale adventure stories have gotten fairly stale, and I want to know what this season's going to do something different with the later episodes being released. But as it is now, I could not recommend it at $17.49. It will drop in price, and it will actually probably get closer and closer to cheap by the time it actually gets to the full release of the last episode. Of course, we have Batman Arkham Knight, which I own on this account, so I can't tell you what the price actually is. I got it for a very, very reasonably cheap price. I'm just checking to see here if it's actually anything listed. No, it doesn't have the price listed there at all. Oh, God, that's annoying. Well, if it actually is lower than the price, it's down 40% off. So I'm assuming it's actually down in the round, but the range of maybe about $17 at 40% off for Batman Arkham Knight. Batman Arkham Knight without the season pass, not so much a great deal. Batman Arkham Knight with the season pass included for $17, definitely a good deal. There's enough content with the extra characters, with the Mad Hatter, with side adventure with Killer Croc, with the kind of side adventure with Two-Face, and all the extra kind of like crime missions and all those extra like playable character kind of side parts with you playing as Harley Quinn or playing as Knight or Nightwing and whatever else. All great. Oh, and Batgirl. I actually really enjoy the A Matter of Family story with Batgirl. All of those little kind of small extra additions make Arkham Knight worthwhile playing. Problem that I have with the main game itself is too many tank missions, too many driving missions. The Batmobile is cool and awesome, but you spend way too much time sitting driving around in that rather than actually kicking ass as a street vigilante and doing investigations. The investigative components look amazing, which there was so much more of those where you track somebody around and reconstruct a scene after they've been attacked or whatever. enjoy Batman Arkham Knight for what it is. It's a great finale to the Arkham series, but it's not the best game I have ever played. It's not the best game in the series itself. Arkham City holds that regard still. So I recommend checking out Arkham Knight at $17 or around about the $17 to $18 mark if you can get it with the season pass. Maybe up to $20, but outside of that, maybe not. Hitman intro package, the complete first season. So, the first season of the Hitman missions, I played the beta and only got through, I only did the beta mission that was available for the test run. Hitman series has not been any better than this now. This is actually a great Hitman game. I want to know more about the plot, but I couldn't bring myself to spend the large price on the season pass. And with it still sitting at about $35.99, I still won't be buying this. Saving a percentage of 40-50% off of this, down to about $30, still not... not my personal value of choice. Meanwhile, a lot of other people will get Hitman because there's just the variety of options of murdering people that you get in it. And apparently what I've seen from the season pass content is that there's a lot of missions to play. There's a lot of interesting ways to do them. So if you are a massive Hitman fan from the years back, you've probably already bought this. But at $35.99, it's an alright price. For me, as not a like a stealth killer person, like a person who doesn't play stealthy games that much, I don't see the mass appeal to it for me. So at this price, I would skip over it and not bother. Star Wars Battlefront at $13.99, the deluxe edition, which probably includes the season passy content of the Battle of Aku and whatever else. I personally think that people should be still affronted at Battlefront for the way it originally came out. At $13.99, that seems to be a lot closer of a comfortable price. The visuals in Battlefront and the sound design are absolutely amazing. It looks gorgeous, it sounds gorgeous, but it felt to me whenever I was playing it was very reduced down. It felt like a very, very repetitive kind of like over and over again same locations, same actions and same methods and same meta going on whenever you're in the gameplay. Wouldn't hold my interest for too long. Multiplayer content like that never really does, but for other people this could be a solid month of play and then maybe moved on from. Star Wars Battlefront Deluxe Edition at $13.99, 65% off, probably down to about $11 if you're actually going to be on PS Plus. Actually quite viable at that price. I could see it actually being, if you're a multiplayer into squad combat kind of stuff and you like the Star Wars franchise, at $11, you couldn't really beat that price for a while. Now, I don't think it's ever going to really get that much cheaper than that, so this is a decent Black Friday pickup. Hard to say it for me because I don't like Battlefront, but good price is a good price. You can't really beat that. Bully, Canis Canem Edit, for the PS2 originally and then moved on to the PS4. At $10.49, if you want to play a game that shows you what could be done with GTA if they stopped making fucking GTA, Bully is it. If you want a GTA that's almost on the line that you could give your kids to play, go for it. If you want to show them a style game from a couple of years back that's very familiar with them and they'd actually be able to pick up the controls for it very easily, get it. At $10.49, I don't know if you could actually pick up a copy of Canis Canem Edit for a really cheap price. I think it's one of those games that actually is not rare, but you wouldn't see it sitting on shelves too often. At $10.49, it's alright for a PS4 upgrade. The game looks a bit pants, but you're kind of expecting that whenever you're looking at games from GTA San Andreas or GTA 3 as well. It's just the age of the game. The graphics have aged over the years. Bully at $10.49. It's only a 30% discount, but it could be a very fun play for people who like the style of game but aren't legally allowed to play GTA yet. I think the age limit on this is probably down to about 15 or PG-13. The content isn't as grotesque as a lot of people made it out to be whenever the game originally came out. Again, it had a lot of consternation because it was called Bully. People assumed it was you're going to be a bully. It was more about the fact that you actually were a kid in a school that would have had bullies or in the kind of private boarding schools that actually... You see a lot of weird people grow up in. No, I don't mean those people are weird, but I mean just there's a lot of weirdities about the idea of literally living in your school for a period of time. Like, essentially, imagine Harry Potter, but if they were all slightly delinquenty, which essentially would mean quite a lot of Slytherin. But either way, I'm not bad-mouthing Slytherin either. If you're a Slytherin kin, I don't mean to disparage you, but Hufflepuff forever. It's a Red Dead Revolver out from PS2 to the PS4 for $10.49. These PS2 games actually at $10.49 price line still feel like an irksome thing for me. Red Dead Revolver, definitely not worth the $10 mark, especially if you're a huge Red Dead Redemption fan. You're going to be going back to a game that's nothing like what you were playing in Red Dead Redemption. Red Dead Revolver was a good series, good title to kind of kick off that series. So if you want a bit of history, it's worth checking out, but I'm sure this will drop in price over time, so you'd probably wait until it's below the $8.50 mark before it's worthwhile, or pick up a copy for it on the PS2 and pick yourself up a PS2 probably for around about the same price, and then it gives you access to all of those games that existed. So across to The Witcher 3 Blood and Wine, which appears to be an additional level. So I don't know if this is actually included in the complete package of Witcher 3. It should be if it's called the goddamn complete package, but if you don't already have that and you had the original game like I did, $14.99 for Blood and Wine, which apparently is a huge amount of content for its last package, so $15 for an expansion. This will get cheaper over time, but if you're a Witcher fan who has burned through the original game and campaign and you want to get something to kind of extend that lifetime, in the PS Plus, I'm sure it's up to about 30-35% off, so you can get this for about $10. It's a $10 expansion that's probably bigger than most expansions of every other game you've ever played, so might be worth your while. And of course, Tom Clancy's The Division, which was unbelievably broken at one point. I don't know if they resolved it and fixed all the problems, but I would never, ever, 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 ever want to go back to the PvP in that game. So Tom Clancy's The Division at $24.99, even though it's 50% off, no thank you. I'm done. The beta was alright. I enjoyed the story that was actually shown in the beta. I wish that was actually a little bit more involved and heavier and actually involved kind of like going off and doing more things. But no, at $24.99, that's not my cup of tea. I like the style. I like the weapons. I essentially like the fact that it's an action-y RPG. It reminds me a lot of kind of the same games I would have played, but also in a sci-fi slant like Fantasy Star Online and stuff. But no. Just no. This game taught itself wrong in its very beginning and has scrambled to recover itself since, but the gameplay is very, very heavily broken. Mad Max on the PS4, 50% off at $9.99. Yes, this is a really fun game, but I leave it with the little kind of the disparaging mark on the side that it's a big, open, massive world where you'll be doing the exact same thing over and over again. That's the biggest problem that Mad Max has. It's a great license choice. It works really well with the style of game they're playing. The world looks fantastic. The movie mode in it, oh, I'm going to buy this just for how I can do an episode of Game with a View, because there's some gorgeous, gorgeous shots in this. There's some gorgeous little kind of cutscenes in it. There's some really, really nice stuff in Mad Max. It's just the big, long gap between a lot of things happening because you're running around in a wide open world gathering flags, feathers, scrap, and side missions. It's a very desolate place. That makes sense for Mad Max. But I could have stood to have a little bit more character involvement closer in between, rather than actually feeling a little bit too disconnected from the storyline that I was doing. It feels like I've gone off to do the thing I was going to do and then ignored it for hours on end. But for a lot of people, that could be a very valid reason why. If you liked Assassin's Creed 1 or 2 and had a lot of fun doing the collecting absolutely everything, 100%ing throughout that game, you will fucking love this. And for me, I can see the reason why. I could enjoy good parts of it, but $9.99, definitely worth a buy. $9.99, worth a buy. If it's cheaper than that on the PS Plus, definitely worth a buy. So this is actually a good deal as part of the Black Friday. I highly recommend Mad Max. Great game, but not a brilliant game. You know, like it's in that good solid 6.57 out of 10, says IGN. So yeah, recommend Mad Max. Borderlands, the Handsome Collection for $23.99. I have seen this deal so much cheaper than this. I've seen it down to about $17, $18 before in past sales, and that's on both UK and American sales. Borderlands, the Handsome Collection, it's a good package. It's Borderlands 1, 2, and pre-sequel. That's a lot of game. That is a lot of game for $23. I enjoy Borderlands 2. Especially enjoy Borderlands 2 as Gage or the Psycho, not the main characters you originally got. So getting all the DLC content for those games included is a really worthwhile expense if you have not played any of the Borderlands games. But with the caveat, realize that these games are not story-based and not story-heavy. In conjunction with Tales from the Borderlands and this, if you're going to have a Borderlands Christmas, if you wanted a Gearbox Borderlands Christmas, this could solidly hold you for the entirety of the time. You play through pre-sequel, and then play a couple episodes of Tales from the Borderlands, then play through episode one of Borderlands, or play through episode one of Borderlands, and then do the pre-sequel, and then do two, you'd actually kind of get a really nice feel for the world of the game, which is something that I really enjoy about the Borderlands series. The world's really fun and interesting, but and funny. Wonderfully funny in a lot of different ways. But the pricing at $23.99, I'm not too sure about it. With all the expansion-y stuff that comes with Borderlands 2 and all the expansion-y stuff in Borderlands 1, I could see it actually being a really good deal. But I have seen it for cheaper in the past, and I hope it actually goes back to that. Of course, with the PS Plus deal on top of this, with probably another 10%, you're chatting down to about $20. At $20, this is one of those games that's on that line. Definitely worth it, and just a little bit over the top. $23.99, a little bit over the top, down to $20. Yeah, worth it. So I'd recommend it on the if you have PS Plus. So Dragon Ball Z, or no, Dragon Ball Xenoverse. Yeah, I already own this game. With the special deal that I was doing for people that enjoy Xenoverse 1 and 2, I could personally recommend Xenoverse with its Season Pass and ignoring Xenoverse 2 altogether if it is massively cheaper. I enjoy the Dragon Ball world, but I'm not a massive fan of it. I just grew up watching the TV show, so I kind of enjoy seeing all the cutscene-y extra bits that are in it. The game has, it's Mission, point, repeat. I ended up playing the game one night, and a guy took me through one of the highest level missions because he was maxed out to help me power level my character, which was great, but I got very little enjoyment of actually playing through any of the rest of the missions afterwards. Dragon Ball Xenoverse is a game that it's got Japanese completionism in mind. It's going to take you a long time to play. You could really enjoy it, but I'd recommend it being with... If you have a couple of friends that have this game, play it with them. If you don't, it really doesn't have that much appeal as a single player. The communication and the crowds that are around you are not brilliant. They expect you to know the missions, know the levels before you go in, which isn't a great way to kind of get into the game. Otherwise, you'll get left behind and be completing the mission before you even realize it started. Okay, Destiny upgrade for going from probably the Taken King onwards. I personally don't have it because I've played, I've got Destiny on a different console, a different account on my UK account. Destiny upgrade, if it's down to about $20, maybe, but otherwise I can't really tell you much because it's unavailable to me in the store because I don't have the package ready and available. Assassin's Creed Syndicate at $15, $14.99, with a 70% discount on Syndicate. I could see it being an enjoyable experience, but I don't know. Maybe it's just natural burnout over the years that I essentially got as far as Unity, and I just didn't care anymore. I don't care about the Assassin's Creed universe. I don't care about the gameplay. I don't know about the innovations that are going to be going into it. I'm a little bit annoyed about the historical inaccuracies and changes that they make. Assassin's Creed as a series, I'm glad it's taking a break now to kind of reassess itself, especially with the movie coming out this year. If you are a big fan of the Assassin's Creed series, with the game down to about $10 with the PS Plus upgrade, or the PS Plus extra discount on top of it, yeah, if you're an Assassin's Creed fan, why not? At $10, it's a why not, because you're going to, it's a game style that you know, a game style that you like, and a world that you might actually enjoy seeing with the association with being in London, isn't it? Syndicate's London? Yeah. All the glitches and flaws tend to be fixed at this point now. Whenever the games came out, especially with Unity, I was not seeing any of the problems in the early parts of the game that other people were complaining about, and I was going like, right, I'm sure it must be whenever you've been playing it for a fair few hours, or someone's gotten a little bit too confused in itself, or there's a lot of changes you've made to the world, but I didn't run into many of the major issues. So with a 70 to 80% discount on Assassin's Creed Syndicate down to about $10, I would say pull the trigger on it. If you've never played an Assassin's Creed game, I still think Black Flag is the best one to get. If you've never played an Assassin's Creed game, play Black Flag. And if you like Black Flag, realize that it's the only game like it in the series, and then maybe play Unity. But I think they had a really good pirate simulator in Black Flag that it could have spun off to be in its own series in a different way. But they decide, of course, to move on and go back into the cities. So with Assassin's Creed Syndicate, it's back to what's very similar to AC 1 and 2. But with a more Cockney slanging, rhyming slang added in, at $10, why not? $15? Personally, not my personal preference. Just Cause 3, the XL edition. Just Cause, I enjoy it on PC, don't enjoy it on consoles, because the modding community on the PC is massive. The Just Cause 2 multiplayer mod was amazing fun. I didn't really get into Just Cause 3, so I can't give a very non-biased opinion on it, but at $30, still way too much. Obviously, the XL edition is all expansion-y, all season pass, all extra content, which includes the flying fortress and the jetpacks and everything else, which is the fun lunacy. Just Cause 3, I imagine for anybody who's into destructive entertainment, it does have some of the most gorgeous explosions I've ever seen. And there is a lot of content involved, but this XL edition will get cheaper with time. And you will probably see it at a better deal at some point in the future. If you're not desperate to play Just Cause 3, $30 is still a little bit too large for it, even if it is all the future content that may well still be coming for it. Witcher 3, Hearts of Stone, $7.49 for another expansion piece for The Witcher 3. Said it before, if you're going to play The Witcher 3, you might as well buy the complete edition, get absolutely everything included in it, because the completionism, if you're going to go into it properly, is well worth it. Just Cause 3, without all the extra crap, is down to $10 cheaper than that. Nah. At only $10 cheaper, still nah. And that's just for the playing game, so you're not getting any of the ridiculously cool weird shit, like the air fortresses and flying in units, and nah. Not at that price, not worth it. Mega Dimensional have Neptunia 7. I know this series because I actually went to play it on the PS3 and then never really got into it. At $7.49, I will sit through probably near any Japanese RPG that is very heavily focused on text-based adventure and information with a very randomized dungeon involvement. It's a JRPG for $7.49. Whenever its price is at $49.99, that's only because the going to find a copy of it anywhere else is going to be difficult. Mega Dimensional Hand Neptunia 7. If you don't know already, essentially it's all the consoles of all the previous generations represented by a Moe girl character who will have hyper trans-dimensional evolutions that make her wear less clothing. It is as weirdly weeaboo as you can get weeaboo, I suppose, in a lot of ways. I'm probably going to play through it a little bit for the channel. At $7.49... and you like JRPGs, it's a punt. It's worth the punt as a JRPG fan to play. If you've never got, if even though it's like number 7 in the series, don't worry about that. You could probably understand it. I mean, it'll tell you in extremely long detail what happens and what is actually going on. It will be unbelievably slow slog through text-based conversations. But whenever you get to the combat, you'll get to the combat. It's at $7.49. It's a long game. If not a great game. Best way to describe it. Sniper Elite 3 Ultimate Edition for $13.99. If you like shooting people in the kneecaps and watching the kneecap explode, this is the game for you. If you like shooting Nazis in the jaw and want to see the jawbone separate from their face as it passes through one side, then the other side, and only tearing through their throat, this is the game for you. If you want to kill Hitler again, this is the game for you. At $13.99, I'm not really fussed. I'm not a sniper person. I've never been a great sniper person. But this game is entertaining in its own way. It's a very, very niche market for itself. As a sniper ranger, you could have a lot of fun. At $13.99, this is a game that is for a niche interest I recommend, but also don't really get into myself. It's the best way to describe it. So $13.99, probably with a 10% discount on top of that, down to about $10 on the PS Plus. It's a buy. It's a game I could say you should go and buy. You can get that. I recommend you get that. The Warriors, $10.49 for the Warriors from PS2 to PS4. Warriors, come out and play. I don't have a glass bottle to do this with. $10.49, PS2 game up to PS4. I still think the game should not cost this much whenever they're being PS2 games upgraded to PS4. I think they really should be below the $10 mark, and then with a discount down to about $8. But this is the PSN's pricing scheme. At $10.49, I'd say no. If it was $7, yes. So we're on that gradient line. The Warriors was a kind of scrolling beat-em-up action game based on the Warriors movie. If you've seen the movie and you like it, then you'll like this license. If you don't know anything about the Warriors, go and watch the movie and decide it on that. There you go. Problem solved. Mega Man Legacy Collection. Being able to play all the original Mega Mans for $7.49. I know I have this on PS3. The difference between it and PS3 and PS4 are going to be negligible at best, considering the fact these are versions of the original NES games. So at $7.49, if you are a retro fan and you absolutely fucking hated Mighty No. 9, this is a decent deal for you. You can get to play through the original Mega Man games with their original difficulties, probably with a save game system as well now implemented, I'm almost sure, because there's no way they're going to make you do the passwords for this. So yeah, Mega Man, go through your legacy experience of shooting little lemon pebbles at robots. Have fun with that. I personally don't abhor the Mega Man series. I loved them back in the NES days, but I'll probably never go back to them. But at $7.49 for, what is it, 6-7 games of the Mega Man series, you could probably go while away a good day kind of showing your kids how to play these games and let them kind of get killed over and over again until they lose their shit. But at $7, it's kind of worth the price. Of course, probably with an extra 10% discount down to about $5 on PS Plus, I would actually have no qualms about buying this. Street Fighter V, 2016 Season Pass, $17.99 for the 6 characters that they released on the Season Pass, which I think was Guile and the Ibuki and Makoto, the karate expert, and Gil, I think. I don't know. The characters I saw that were released in the Season Pass, don't care. Really don't care for them. Let's see what we got in here. We're just double checking to make sure it has them listed. Oh, sorry. So it's Urien, Juri, Balrog, Ibuki, Guile, and Alex. Now, Street Fighter V. I love the Street Fighter series, but the original release of the game without its story mode, I don't know. At $17 for 6 characters, which you can get through in-game play, admittedly a lot of in-game play, unless those characters really appeal to you or you plan to play competitively online, don't really care. It's a season pass for $18. Whenever we get to the full game, we'll talk more about it. Assassin's Creed Unity for $11.99. Of course, with a slightly larger discount. As I said before, if you can, get Black Flag, play it. If you don't like Black Flag, then don't worry about ever playing the rest of the series ever again. If you enjoy Black Flag and you want a little bit more, you can move on to Unity. A lot of the problems have been fixed from the patches that people have put through for this. So people's complaints that had whenever the game came out with the missing faces and stuff is much less of a problem now. Assassin's Creed Unity is a much more fixed game. I can't recommend it for its story content because I really just didn't get into it, but for a beautiful PS4 developed world of assassins running through windows and diving through buildings, you can only get better with Syndicate, and Syndicate, personally, I didn't really enjoy the world of as much as even the Paris, so yeah, Assassin's Creed Unity, pretty cheap. So step one, play Black Flag. If you like Black Flag, maybe play Unity and pay for it at this price. So you've got a little bit of a timeline to get it done before this Black Friday sale is finished. Game of Thrones Season Pass for the entirety of the season for $4.99. If you were buying the Telltale Games big, massive Season Pass bundles, which is actually all the games, yes, definitely. I have not played any of the Game of Thrones. Oh, no, that's a lie. I played through the first episode of the Game of Thrones season, and I made some horrible decisions, and some very, very good people got killed. If you're a Game of Thrones fan, you're probably going to enjoy the hell out of this because it is violent, it is in canon with the TV series, and it's entertaining in its own way. It's a Telltale game, so of course you know it's going to dovetail into an inevitable murder fest of some sort. But yeah, it's going to be part of my Tell Us a Tale series whenever I get into playing the rest of the episodes. But Game of Thrones, $5 for an entire season of the game. Reasonably worthwhile, not quite as much as my recommendation for Tales from the Borderlands because I think it's an amazing 5-episode series. Game of Thrones is still worth a play. Try and get it within a season pass bundle. If you're going to go to the bother of buying 2 or 3 of the season passes in this batch, which will be the Walking Dead 1 and 2 and whatever else, grab it. If you're only going to be grabbing one of these season passes for Telltale Games, get Tales from the Borderlands. I recommend it much more. Game of Thrones is, of course, available to you at $5, which isn't bad. It's not bad at all. It's just at $2.99 for the best series, in my opinion, of the Telltale Games. I think they should be price matching their own seasons. But of course they can't because of it being licensed materials. So Grand Theft Auto Vice City for $10.49? Nah. Why not? Because you can get a Grand Theft Auto bundle, which is Vice City, San Andreas, and 3 for about probably $17-$20. A lot of times whenever it's on sale. It has been on sale very recently for less than this. So $10.49, no, it's a PS2 upgrade. Why the fuck are they doing that? I'm going to get annoyed if I have to keep fucking going through these. So, Trackmania Turbo for $14.79. Yeah. At $14.79, why not? Trackmania is a long-running game series that allows you to do death-defying, ridiculously gravity fucking stunts with multiple vehicles over hundreds upon thousands of tracks with hundreds of thousands of other players. It's a very simple game. It doesn't require very precise, mad precise controls. I used to play this game one-handed in a net cafe back in the early 2000s. Trackmania is fun. Is it $15 worth of fun? It could very well be if you're actually the kind of person who likes to zone out to a race game where you only have to do one or two laps of a course at any one period of time to try and get the best score. The online multiplayer way, it's kind of like a ghosted involvement where you see all the other racers but you can't touch them or you don't affect them in any way, shape, or form, and it's about just getting your best times. It can be fun. The scoreboard and the way it's delineated down for where locations where like you can be like the top 100 in Ireland specifically. Or you could be in the top, you're like number 27 million in the world, but you're still like the top 100 in Ireland because only maybe 5,000 people play it. I like that delineation. There's customization of the vehicles. There is track building in this, as far as I know. I can't remember. Pretty sure it is. Yeah, there's track building in this, which you can then share and everybody else can play on. At $15, it matters what your personal involvement will be. If you're just playing through the campaign mode, at $15, it's actually a decent price. If you're going to be into creating your own tracks in this and really getting into the community that is Trackmania on top of that, yeah, it's a great console involvement, but I highly recommend it on PC instead. At $15, why the hell not? I own it personally on my other account. I wouldn't actually have it on my American account because I like to be able to play it under my own name. So, Star Wars Battlefront, on its own, with none of its expansion-y stuff, as the original gameplay experience that was released back whenever it came out, fuck it at $10. Nah, it's not worth it at $10. This game, although it looks beautiful and sounds beautiful, for what it was whenever it originally came out, it's garbage. The only addition of this you should even look at in contemplation is the addition with all the extra content added in. That's just my opinion on it. So a $10.49 original Star Wars Battlefront, really hard to recommend. Really, really hard to recommend. So The Witcher 3 Witch Hunt, of course I own this on my account without all the expansion-y stuff. I recommend the complete version if you are going to play through the whole thing. If you're just curious and just kind of passingly interested in the Witcher 3 series, or the Witcher series itself, then this might be the one to go for. It'll be cheaper, it'll be in about the $14, $12 mark, because I can't tell with the pricing. What is it saying actually, how much the discount was? 50% off? Shit, yeah, man. That's probably going to be down to about, I don't know, it's going on until the 29th. At down at that price, there's probably, you're chatting about $11-$12 for the original Witcher 3. Yeah, man. It's a lot of game for that kind of money. If you haven't played it before and you like a Western RPG, yeah, you'll really get into this. You don't have the customization of character because you're playing as Geralt of Rivera, but you'll really get into the world. The lore in the world, if you're into that kind of stuff in a game, it'll eat you up. It'll eat up your time. You're guaranteed probably, 50 to 80 hours in this game whenever you're playing through it, really. It really is. If you're that kind of person, you'll get into it. Bound. The only thing I've seen of Bound is the trailer and the photo competition that they're running on SEEA, or the European kind of like Sony Twitter page. It looks gorgeous. I'm assuming it's kind of like a rhythm action-y game. At $11.99, it seems like one of those experimental experiences, which also has a PSVR function built into it. At $11.99, I don't know. I honestly couldn't give you a definitive answer to whether or not it's worth it. And but with the PS Plus membership down to $9, it reminds me a lot of a couple of other games that were kind of like very, like a Resi kind of things, like games where the experience itself is going, like, there's something really calming and direct and kind of engaging with it while you're playing it, but you won't play it for too long. So below the $10 mark with the PS Plus deal, yeah, I'd actually give that a try. The Crew Complete Edition. Driving. Yeah. Down to $13.19 without an expansion or an extra bit for PS Plus. Do you want to drive in a crew with your friends? Do you have a group of friends that you could play online with already? Do they already own the crew? There you go. Answer for there. Like, all those questions just answer your question for you. Wolfenstein, The Old Blood. I enjoyed the Wolfenstein game, like the main game. The Old Blood is a standalone expansion in its own way. At $9.99, if you liked Wolfenstein, if you've played through the New Order and want to play a little bit more in that world, The Old Blood's there for you. It's $9. Not a big ask, but I was done with the New Order whenever I finished the New Order. This is more of the same. can't really argue against that. It's just, it's entertaining to play, but it feels like a much more, almost like a survival mode version of their Wolfenstein game. Excuse me, I'm starting to run out of air because I'm actually been talking so long. Guilty Gear Xrd Revelator for $17.99. If you're a Guilty Gear fan, if you're a BlazBlue fan, if you're a 2D fighter fan, if you like the extremely in-depth combat-based fighters that are coming out of that environment, I can't remember what's the name of the, I can't remember the name of the company that makes these bloody games or keeps releasing them. Oh, I'm starting to completely blanking on them. That's a bad sign. But Guilty Gear, BlazBlue, Chaos Code, those kind of like the all ones released by that same company. This is the most recent one in the series. It's not that old. There was a demo floating about for it a while back, but you could only get it if you had pre-ordered the game. At $17.99, I'm assuming the game either has not sold extremely well or is one of those games that got immediately very competitive on the online market and a lot of the casual players have fallen away. But the Guilty Gear series and the BlazBlue series tend to have a very interesting story mode to them. They tend to be quite heavily story-based. So, like Persona 4 Arena or BlazBlue, Chrono, Phantasm, Extend, Gear Shift, Guilty Gear, of course, continues on the series of Guilty Gear. At $17.99, personally, as a 2D fighter fan, I'd get into that. If it has a discount for PS Plus? No, it doesn't. At $17.99, I could get into that. I could get into it for just to play and just hammering through the story mode for at least the one time. But for anybody else who's really into the competitive side of gaming, $17.99 is probably a no-brainer to play the Guilty Gear series. To get into the new characters, get into the new methodologies, and get into the new timings of the characters. I'm sure you probably wanted it whenever it originally came out if you're really that into those kind of games. But if you're not, but you're still casually interested, the only thing I recommend is probably to never get into them online multiplayer because you will get your ass trounced unless you're beating the main game on its highest difficulty with absolute casual ease. Far Cry Primal Digital Apex Edition for $19.49. Far Cry Primal, to me, felt like it should have been an expansion to the most recent Far Cry, like Blood Dragon. This should not be a standalone game, so it should not be at standalone prices. $19.49 is expansion-y prices, so it feels a little bit more appropriate, but I don't see there ever being anything added to this game as it is. So Digital Apex Edition is whatever you get as expansion-y extra bits, probably a couple of mounts or whatever else. If you can get it for the cheaper version, go for the cheaper version. If not, wait for this game to drop in price. The intro pack for Hitman. So this is like the first couple of missions of Hitman, not the season pass. At $8.99 for an introduction to the Hitman game, to encourage you to buy each episode as you may feel like it, whenever they've all been released already. You could easily pick up the season pass for the price I said earlier on. Probably, like I said, $35 is too much for the Hitman series to buy up front if you haven't played it before. This is the intro pack at $8.99, which is the first couple of missions. Prologue, Paris. I enjoyed it. This is the bit that I actually would have been in the beta that I played. $8.99 for Hitman, for a single mission. Take that to mean what you will. A single mission of Hitman could keep you for 25 minutes, or it could keep you for 4.5 hours. So take that value to it. It matters how, what way you play a game like Hitman. If you played any of the games in the previous series, you'll understand what I mean by that. If not, essentially it's just that there's a many, many, many approaches to doing the same action over and over again. So it matters your mindset whenever it comes to playing video games. So Hitman package at $8.99, maybe worth it. And as you can see, the rest of them are sitting here at $5.99 or more for the other episodes. Naruto Shippuden, Storm, Ninja Storm, number 4. So this is near to the end, but not the end of Naruto Shippuden, as included by the deluxe, the ending of Naruto Shippuden itself, the final kind of Ninja Genji Wars, whatever else. It looks like the fight's coming near to the end, even just on the front page of this. I don't know if this carries us all the way through to the actual end of the series, but at $23.99, if you're a Naruto Shippuden fan, you probably already bought it, but for me, no. I'm not a huge fan of the Naruto Shippuden Ninja Storm series, just because it's the same as the Xenoverse games. You can get really into it, or you can not. If I was going to be playing through these games just to kind of get a HD CG version of the story mode, or the actual context of the TV series, I might actually be into it. But as a fighting game, no. I don't find the fun in it. So, it matters. Your fandom carries whether or not this is of value to you. $23.99? Maybe. $31.99? Nah, not really at all. Fairy Fencer F, Advent Dark Force at $17.99. This game seemed unbelievably expensive whenever I first saw it at $60. But down to $11.99? That's almost appropriate. I could get into this. So again, same as hyperdimensional Neptunia, I would play this game, but not really for the fact that I kind of really want to play it, but more the fact going like, I just want to keep my toe dipped in the JRPG culture that gets released on the PS4, and I want to encourage this kind of stuff. Maybe it's what the game that you want to play, but I saw that there's a shitload of DLC for this, for no real apparent reason, other than the fact to have multiple costumes and relatable items for your characters. If you like Moe girls, Moe fairy girls, and a shonen protagonist, sure, get into the Fairy Fencer series. I don't know it otherwise myself, so with a very heavily text-based conversational kind of bit going on, back and forth, and less kind of action-y entertainment, old-school JRPG content, your measurement of enjoyment will go so far. $11.99, yeah. At $17.99, no. So it matters whether or not you're on PS Plus and if you're into JRPGs. You can see it. This is one of the few ones I'm actually going to show the trailer for, because it's really hard to explain what I'm looking at otherwise. This is an open-worldy kind of like JRPG game, but all the content and all the conversations are going to be done with these text-based kind of boxes and stuff. Get into it as much as you feel like, as much as you'll enjoy it. Not for me. Far Cry Primal at $14.99. Yeah, that's what I said. The expansion-y prices for Far Cry Primal. Yeah, if you like the world, go for it. $14.99. That's not an offensive price to me. Anything above that, no. At $15, that is the absolute top limit that I would have for Far Cry Primal. Of course, again, Hitman. Minecraft Story Mode for the entire season pass at $14.99. This game can suck my ass. You can go and check out an episode of the playthrough of the Minecraft Story Mode up on my channel. If you're going to charge $5 for Game of Thrones and $2.99 for Tales from the Borderlands, you cannot charge $15 for fucking Minecraft Story Mode. It's trying to be funny. It's trying to be memey. If your kids are 8 or 9 years old or below, they'll get a massive giggle out of this. Anybody over that age, it is not worth $15. That can just go fuck itself. That $11.99 even with a PS Plus discount? Nah, man. Not worth it. So $29.99 for Street Fighter V. I was saying this earlier on. Did a $19.79 with the PS Plus, and then the same thing with the Season Pass included for what? $49? $44? And down to $29? Yeah. Street Fighter V. If you're into the fighting genre, Street Fighter V is a great, interesting, fun game. But at this kind of prices, nah. I mean, what was it down to about a month ago? It was down to about £24, so that's about, what, $40? So at $44 for it's not even that much cheaper or more expensive to me to buy it in American. I don't know. I find it really difficult to kind of like narrow down why I don't like Street Fighter as it is now, but I don't want to actually be buying these season passes year in, year out for extra content the same way I might do for Dead or Alive last round. Admittedly, it's a completely different thing where you get full sets of characters, but damn, I don't know if I like the way street fighting games have kind of gone into, because they are niching themselves into nicheness of niching to get into the niche of the niche. It really, really is. If you're into that genre and series, you're going to follow them anyway. So at these prices, not for the casual, much more for the people outside. At $29.99, I might be interested in playing through the story mode once, maybe, but it needs to, for me, it would have to be lower than that even. It would need to be main game $17 with the first season expansion down to $29. That would be the sweet spot for me to probably jump on board with the Street Fighter series. J-Star's Victory Versus Plus. Played the game, enjoyed it. At $15, I mean, there's a long enough story mode in this. It's kind of a fun action game. If you're into Shonen Jump and the main characters from all those series, it's alright. But I didn't find the combat that engaging, and I didn't really find it entertaining. So, if you kind of like arena fighters that have really goofy, unbalanced, unmatched OP characters against each other, you might get a massive kick out of this. I personally didn't enjoy the J-Star series, but at $14.99, it's not a bad price. It's another Japanese anime game that down to $11.99 that might hold your attention forever or hold your attention for an hour.
but because it has a lot of different characters from different series, you might get a massive kick out of seeing them all if you're actually a big anime watching fan. Naruto Shippuden Ultimate Ninja Storm 4 Deluxe Edition? I don't know why. Like, Ultimate Ninja Storm, we've already seen this. We've seen Ninja Storm 4. But why is this one at $23 and the other one at $59? Hang on, we need to go back here and find out. What's the difference between them? Where was it? Where was it? Alright, $31. Alright, Deluxe Edition. Assuming that had hidden characters or extra characters unlocked, this game down at $23.99. You're paying a difference for that just so you can actually play extra characters. It really is a question of your fandom. If you're a massive fan, then you're going to go for it. If not, you're not going to bother. Sword Art Online, Lost Song. Personally, not a big fan of the Sword Art Online games. There's a new one coming out soon. Lost Song was enjoyable, and so was Hollow Fragment. The next one's going to be Hollow Realization. There seems to be no change in the gameplay in them. Again, 3D action game. It kind of feels like you're playing Phantasy Star Universe with an overarching kind of like text-based plot that goes along with it. Not my cup of tea anymore. I played through a bit of the first one. I bought the second one for my nephew to play. He really enjoys it. He enjoys going through the 4x4 dungeons, and he likes the world of Sword Art Online. I personally think I'm watching this and going like, why the hell is there not a new Dot Hack game? Why am I sitting looking at this whenever there should be a Dot Hack game already out? But no, it continues on. It's a behemoth path, and a lot of people don't... It's very fashionable to hate on Sword Art Online now. I like the parts of it. I just don't think it actually deserves to be the more popular than its predecessors that came before it. Tales of Zestiria, I've had it sitting on that shelf for a long time to play just off screen from you guys, and I haven't even touched it. I tried Tales of Berseria, and it put me off playing another Tales of game. Zestiria, it looks interesting. At $23, no. Not that interesting. Again, JRPG, heavily involved content, $17.99. You could probably get a good enjoyment out of that. The action in it seems to be kind of active time-based, with a bunch of characters all acting at once. I'm sure Berseria is not representative of the quality and the type of all of the other games, but the Tales of series really don't... I can imagine them being, since there's like 13 games in the series, they're being like the modern Final Fantasy. People who grew up playing these games will play every single one of them. At $17 for you guys, great price. Anybody else, it's not impenetrable, but it seems to be a style and world that doesn't interest me. It reminds me a lot of Eternal Sonata if you played it back on the 360 days and the PS3 days. But Tales of, I think it's just a franchise that's passed me by. Far Cry 4 for $14.79. Yes. $14.79, decent price, down to about $11 if you can get it for it. No, it's only $14.79. Far Cry games, if you like hunting, gathering, preparing, leveling as you play through a game, you can enjoy it. Far Cry 3 kind of really got everybody's attention, Far Cry 4 less so. But the villain was fantastic in this. The villain from Far Cry 3 was better in my opinion. At $14.79, worth a play, but... If you're in for fast action shooty bangs rather than actually hunting, crafting, killing, leveling kind of games, then you're going to have an issue. You're going to have a cognitive dissonance. I'm not a big fan of that in Far Cry, so you're going to have to spend a lot of time running from point to point, lifting up beacons, getting yourself available to different areas. I'm sure you could really enjoy it, but Far Cry 4. Not massively for me, but at this price, it's a very entertaining game for its for the value of content. Grand Theft Auto, the trilogy. As we were looking at earlier on, you can get San Andreas, 3, Vice City, all for $24.49. So if you bought the three of them at $10.49, then that's what you're paying, $5 over the odds. This isn't too bad as a price if you really want to get the retro GTA experience. Those ones are available to you. More Hitman. Dirt Rally. Driving in the rally car. Dirt Rally. Do you like dirt? Do you like rallying? Are you willing to spend $30 on it? Or $23.99? $23.99, actually. If you're into dirt rallying, if you're actually into rally cars and you like the series, $23.99 isn't a bad price. $29.99, not so much. So imagine whether or not you're a PS Plus player, which you're going to need anyway if you're going to be playing the multiplayer content of Dirt. Problem solved. I am Setsuna, referential to the back of the history of JRPG games. That Senti said it's like a throwback to the days of Chrono Trigger and Chrono Cross. Not quite so much. Setsuna, the main character, is not the main character. It feels heavily like it's saying that Yuna was the main character of Final Fantasy X when you played as Tidus. That's what the big thing with this is. it says female protagonist, main leader, but you spend most of your time, you're playing as the anonymous mercenary that's pretty much protecting alongside her. So, yeah, not the main character. I Am Setsuna, interesting game in its own right, but 2679 as an indie title, no. It's not going to hold my attention at 2679. Whenever it gets down to about the $15, $14 mark, yes, I Am Setsuna will actually feel like a viable, purchasable choice for me. Doesn't seem to be that heavy and that involved to require a full price title. But it looks gorgeous. Soundtrack's quite mellow and relaxed, but not something I would actually purchase. Tropico 5 for $7.49. This game was on PS Plus at one point, so if you missed out on PS Plus, you can pick it up for a dirt cheap price. Tropico on console? Not for me. This is a game that I feel like should be played on a PC, mouse, and keyboard, just for the speed of access, resource management. It's like Civ in the same way. The new Civ game has refined itself down to the point where it's really good in control pads, but Tropico 5 definitely doesn't feel like that. It feels very, very convoluted to maneuver around everything. So at $7.49, good price, but if you're not really kind of like got the mental gymnastics to navigate menus and memorize where how many clicks you're going to need to get to where you need to be and the speed that you need to be at it, Tropico 5 can feel a bit of a slog at times. But $7.49, that's what you're trading off. You're trading off the price of enjoyment for control, I suppose, in a way. But as a console game, I didn't dislike it. I just found that it didn't engage me because of the memorization required for the control pad. But Batman Arkham Premium Edition, of course, this is the one that I purchased whenever it came out. What did the price drop down to? Save 40% off? Really? 40% off. Ah, damn it. Well, you can see with the 37 add-ons that are included in the Arkham Knight Premium Edition, that it's... Oh, god damn it, I ended up doing that badly. Perfect, it brought me back to the right page. So, with the Premium Edition, all that extra content is worth it. 40% off, imagine Premium Edition, I have to do it in my head, it was probably $80 down to, what, 40 now, 37, 35? Hard call, but if you're going to buy Arkham Knight, buy the Premium Edition. It's the only one worth getting, in my opinion. The original setup game had a lot of issues missing with it, like a lot of stuff that just didn't feel like it was a full, complete game. With all the extra little missions in this and all the side parts that are added into it, this could keep you entertained for a fairly long time and is of a valuable package. $35 mark is pretty much what my limit would be for this game. If you can get it for cheaper, please, 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 please do. I imagine it's probably down to about, what, $29, $24. So go for it at that price. Digimon Story Cyber Sleuth at $23.99. So, yeah, of all of the Japanese RPGs we've seen in this sale so far, Digimon Story Cyber Sleuth actually holds my attention the most. I'm actually most interested in it because I haven't played a Digimon game since maybe Digimon World on the PS1. I want to play this. I want to play a Pokemon-style game that involves itself in a world that I can wander around and kind of get to enjoy and experience with semi-familiar characters. That's what I would have said whenever this game originally came out. World of Final Fantasy is out now, and it's not that expensive. So the price difference between a $23 copy of this and a $35 copy of World of Final Fantasy, I would buy World of Final Fantasy, which I have been playing on the station, on this channel. So maybe whenever I finish that, I might jump into this. But at $23.99, it's one of those games that it doesn't hold my attention as much. But at $17.99, yes. Again, there's a lot of games that are in this sale that are Japanese RPGs that are much more improved by the discount that you get from PS Plus. From that, taking you from that like slightly annoying $25 mark to below $20, yeah, you've caught my extra bit of attention. First you had my interest, now you have my attention. So across the F1 2016 on the PS4 at $38.99. If you're an F1 racer fan, you probably already own this. Because again, it's a sports, it's a thing, it's a yearly release, there's one every single year. If you really enjoyed the F1 season of 2016, it might hold your attention at $38.99. It does not hold mine's. It really does not. But at $32.99, it still does not hold my attention. F1. If you're into F1, you should have pedals, steering wheels, movable gas-powered seat to be sitting in and everything else. Not my personal interest, but you can see that it's at $39.99. It was at $59.99. It's 35% off. This game will get cheaper. I probably think and expect it that it's a lot cheaper in stores. You can buy a hard copy of this for cheaper than you're going to get in this seal. MX vs. ATV Supercross Encore, $23.99. Is this actually just going to down to $17 as well? Yes, it is. Well, no, down to $20 just. No. Not of my interest. Whoa, undergoing maintenance? They just kicked me out of the store? I was worried there for a second. I think they actually just kicked me out of the store in the middle of my discussion. That's the thing. It's a conspiracy. It is a conspiracy! It is a conspiracy. They're taking me out of the store. Oh, the cheek of them! Oh! Oh! Sony! Sony! Of course, again, that's going to be a big problem with the Black Friday sale being ongoing as it is now. It's booted me out of the store for what I could actually see. Oh man, that is horribly disappointing. So the service is currently undergoing maintenance. We are going to have to stop the video here because obviously I'm not going to be able to get the rest of the content up for this. I will essentially take a look at the rest of the sale items, but obviously you got a good portion of 2/3 of them there. With the Sony network being as it is, of course this video had its limitations. It could only be done while the actual store was open. Without the store being open, I can't really continue on going through the rest of them. I hope there was nothing really important and massive in the entail of that sale that you guys wanted to see or really get my opinions on. But I think I covered as much as I could really do in the first kind of like process there, because I mean that's an hour of sale chat really. The sale is big. There are 110 titles in the sale. I've told you probably about what 50-60 of them, so we're probably missing a few titles at the very end there. Do you know what I'll do? I will do another Black Friday sale item before they go off sale on the 29th, but until then guys, thank you very much for watching. If you want to subscribe to the channel, there's always a button sitting right up there, or if you want to actually see other videos by the series, you can hit the ones on the side. I highly recommend the hype series I'm doing for Final Fantasy 15 and for World of Final Fantasy, so enjoy those, and I'll see you all in the next video. Bye!